to NeuroHub 21 again. It's been so long that NeuroHub 21 didn't release a video. So it's time now that we will study. The core agenda of our today's topic is asthma. Before knowing about asthma, that what actually asthma is, first of all, let us know about the histology of asthma. Not histology of asthma, histology of airways. So I am marking here. Histology of airways, that how airways looks like and what are the layers of cells or muscles or smooth muscles or connective tissue. So I already explained it in chronic bronchitis video. You can go and check there in the playlist of NeuroHub 21. Respiratory playlist of NeuroHub 21. So again, let us discuss about the normal histology of airways, that how does an airway look like. So this green shaded portion, is mucus. Is mucus, and this mucus just go to and fro and back and forth by how movement of cilia, cilia क्या करते हैं कि इस mucus को move कराने का, आगे और पीछे move कराने का काम करते हैं, उसका role play करते हैं. तो cilia helps in the movement of mucus in a normal airway. Now let us see. The first layer of an airway is the pseudocolumnar epithelial cell. It is made up of pseudocolumnar epithelial cell. And which type of pseudocolumnar? Ciliated pseudocolumnar. Let me write it here. Ciliated pseudocolumnar epithelial cell. In this pseudocolumnar epithelial cell, goblet cells are also present, and this goblet cell, note it down guys, mark my words, goblet cell helps in the production of mucus. Below that pseudocolumnar epithelial cell, there present a basement membrane. So this portion is termed as basement membrane. Below basement membrane, loose connective tissue is present. So this portion is called the loose connective tissue. Both together, mark my words guys, note it down, aims special. Both basement membrane and loose connective tissue, I am writing here, this basement membrane and this loose connective tissue, plus loose connective tissue, together called, I mean to say, these two layers together called lamina propria. Okay, so in this lamina propria, this black structure, this black circumscribed structure is termed as mast cells. Mast cells. In this lamina propria, mast cells are present. Another question for you. Mast cells is present where? Where mast cells are present? So what will be your answer? Mast cell is present in the lamina propria of the histology of an airway. Okay guys, and what is the function of mast cell? Mast cell releases some chemical mediators such as histamine and another chemical termed as leukotriene and prostaglandins. So what are the function of histamine, prostaglandin and leukotrienes? Let us see. First of all, histamine and these chemical mediators like histamine, prostaglandin and leukotrienes helps in the bronchoconstriction, constriction of the smooth muscles. So bronchoconstriction karwane ka jo kaam hai wo kiska hai? Mast cells ka. And mast cells are present in the lamina propria. And what is made up of lamina propria is made of two layers, basement membrane and loose connective tissue. Below lamina propria, yeah, below basement membrane and loose connective tissue, there presents a smooth muscle. This brown shaded portion is termed as smooth muscles. This histamine will released in this smooth muscle received by the receptor, and this smooth muscle will get contract, or we are saying this term as bronchoconstriction. And below smooth muscle, there is present a connective tissue. Connective tissue is helps in the sponginess of the muscles. So, in this connective tissue, mucinous glands are present. The green shaded portion here before your screen is the mucinous glands. This mucinous glands helps in the production of the mucus, and it stimulates the goblet cells to release more mucus in the cilia. So this is all about the natural histology of an airway. One more thing to add on here. Likewise, basement membrane plus loose connective tissue is called lamina propria. Then if I add pseudocolumnar epithelial cell, plus basement membrane and loose connective tissue, these three structures together called as mucosa, lamina propria and pseudocolumnar epithelial cell, lamina propria, lamina propria plus pseudo columnar, this layer plus these two layers we are calling it lamina propria. Lamina propria is made up of basement membrane and loose connective tissue. And this lamina propria plus pseudocolumnar epithelial cell is termed as, I'm writing it here, mucosa. This above three layers is termed as pseudocolumnar epithelial cell plus basement membrane plus loose connective tissue. Basement membrane plus loose connective tissue is termed as lamina propria. And when lamina propria is added to the pseudocolumnar epithelial cell, then this term is, these two structures are together formed called mucosa. And below mucosa, below these three structures, this one and this one, below mucosa, smooth muscle plus connective tissue, mark my word guys, smooth muscle plus connective tissue is together called as submucosa. I'm writing it down here, submucosa. सब म्यूकोसा. दीज टू लेयर्स, दीज टू लेयर्स इज टर्म्ड एज सब म्यूकोसा. सो दिस इज द नॉर्मल हिस्टोलॉजी ऑफ एन एयरवे. नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट अस्थमा. आवर टूडेज टॉपिक इज अस्थमा. What actually the pathological changes occurring in the asthmatic condition or in asthmatic lungs, and what is the disease happening, what are the clinical manifestations happening in the asthma. Now let us see. First of all, let me define asthma. What is actually happening in the asthmatic condition? So let me define it first. What is the definition? So asthma is the chronic inflammatory airway disease occurring due to allergic condition. One more thing, important thing to remember here is it is occurring due to the allergic condition, due to allergic conditions. Characterized by. Let me delete it. Characterized by bronchoconstriction. Bronchospasm, we can say first. Second, airway hyper responsiveness. I will explain it. First of all, let it write it down, note it down on your pen and paper. Airway hyper responsiveness. Third, eosinophilic infiltration. Fourth, hyper inflation. So this is the basic definition of an asthma. Asthma is a chronic disorder which is caused by an allergic condition, and it is characterized by four main things. First one is the bronchospasm, that is constriction of the smooth muscles. And why it is constricting? Just because of the histamine release produced by the mast cells, and due to that histamine release, bronchoconstriction or bronchospasm is occurring. And the next thing is airway hyper responsiveness. Due to the advanced stimulus of smoke, fumes, perfume, or any kind of dust particles, what is happening in the airway, that airway gets irritated, and due to that irritation, hyper responsiveness, the patient will breathe very 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 effort. He needs to provide more effort during breathe. So due to that increasing efforts, what is actually happening, that airway hyper responsiveness is occurring. The next thing is eosinophilic infiltration. I will explain it in the pathophysiology section of the asthma that eosinophilic infiltration is occurring. Eosinophils get infiltrated. What is the meaning of infiltration? Infiltration means the accumulation of the eosinophils in the mucus of the patient. So we can, in clinically we can say that when we differentially diagnose the patient of an COPD or an asthma, how will you recognize that it is an asthmatic patient or a COPD patient? आप कैसे पहचानेंगे कि ये व्यक्ति अस्थमा का है या ये व्यक्ति COPD का है? Main difference, sputum के अंदर यदि eosinophils की मात्रा, eosinophil count increase होता है, then this condition is termed as an asthmatic patient. Definitely, this is the classical sign of an asthma, that eosinophil will be seen in the sputum test of the patient. Now, mark it, note it down. Next one is hyperinflation, inflation of the lungs due to air tapping. How this four will occur, I will make it prove these four characteristics of asthma in the pathophysiologic section. First of all, before starting the pathophysiology section, let us see the pathological changes occurring in the asthma, pathological changes occurring in the asthmatic condition. First, eosinophilic infiltration. Eosinophilic infiltration. First pathologic change. Let me note it down. Pathological changes. First pathological change is the eosinophilic infiltration. Infiltration in mucus. That means this is the normal histology of a lung. This is the normal histology of an airway. But what is actually happening in the asthmatic lung? Let us see. This orange one, this orange shaded circumscribed portion, we will see microscopically when we look the histology of an asthmatic lung, what we exactly will see is that eosinophilic infiltration is occurring in the mucus. Normally eosinophils are produced by the bone marrow, it is present in the, but in lungs, in mucus, we will see the characteristic feature of asthma, that is eosinophilic infiltration. Now, next thing, next pathological change. This is the normal quantity of mast cell present in the lamina propria. I already mentioned mast cells is found in the lamina propria, but increase in the production of mast cells. Mast cell will be more in quantity. Next pathological changes, increase in the production of mast cell. This is a second classical pathological change in the asthmatic lung. Third one, increase in the IgE production.
I am denoting
mast cell. I am denoting mast cell
with this black color.
This is mast cell, and I am denoting IgE.
IgE with blue color, blue pen.
This is this cap.
This cap is termed as an IgE. IgE means immunoglobulin E, which is responsible for then allergic conditions. Because asthma is occurring due to allergic condition. That's why IgE is produced inside the airway. So IgE is formed.
IgE production will be seen. IgE production will be
seen in the normal histology of an airway. Now let us see next classical feature.
4. Hypertrophy and hyperplasia.
Increase in the quantity of cell and increase in the number of cell is called hyperplasia, and increase in the size of the cell is called as hypertrophy
of smooth muscle.
Will be the pathological changes seen in an asthmatic lung. So this is the normal anatomical changes, normal pathological changes seen in the histology of an airway in the asthmatic condition. Now let me describe about the causes and pathophysiology of asthma. For that I have to delete this. I hope you note it down, guys. If you didn't note it down, pause the video and note it down on your notebook.
Thank you.
Now asthma is a chronic inflammatory disease characterized by bronchospasm, hyperresponsiveness, eosinophilic infiltration and hyperinflation. Let us discuss about the causes and pathophysiology of asthma. For that,
etiology means your causes. So what will be the etiology? Occupational risk factors. What are the occupational risk factors? What are the various occupations which is triggering? We can say the etiology or triggers. These are the triggers of asthma.
So what are the occupations which is causing asthma?
Farmers, because they are regularly encountering with various agricultural dust.
Okay, so farmers are prone to asthma.
Next, industry, industrial workers, because they are in large amount, they are in exposure with sulfur dioxide gas. Next, sugarcane factory, they are also prone to coal dust.
These are the occupational risk factors.
Animal factors. What are the animal factors? Animal danders means excreta, animal dander. Next, what are the other risk factors such as gases? Which gases? Carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, okay, and fumes.
Then fumes like glutaraldehyde,
okay,
formaldehyde,
perfumes. So these things mean to say, these things causes the trigger for an asthma, asthmatic episode, episode of asthma. Next, certain drugs. Which drugs? Most important,
AIIMS special.
यहाँ से क्वेश्चन उठ के आता है आपके, विच ड्रग्स ट्रिगर अस्थमा? फर्स्ट,
बीटा ब्लॉकर्स,
बीटा एड्रिनर्जिक ब्लॉकर्स.
Why beta blockers? Because beta drugs such as sympathetic drugs such as beta agonist, salbutamol, agonist. What is agonist? Agonist means it works and functions like in favor to the sympathetic system. So that is adrenergic agonist drugs. So वो drugs adrenaline की तरह ही काम करता है. Adrenaline का काम क्या होता है? Bronchodilation. Now in asthmatic condition we are talking about which drugs which is causing trigger. We are talking about blockers, not agonist. We are talking about antagonist. So beta, what is beta adrenergic agonist is doing? Agonist, mark my words, agonist. Agonist is doing bronchodilation. But what will blockers will do? Blockers will bronchoconstrict. Bronchoconstriction will occur. So beta blockers are the drugs which causing, which is inducing asthma. सपोज कोई पेशेंट है, जैसे कोई पेशेंट हार्ट की प्रॉब्लम है उसको, उसका बीपी बहुत ज़्यादा बढ़ा हुआ है, तो हमने उसकी पास्ट मेडिकल हिस्ट्री ली, हमें पता लगा कि उसको अस्थमा था, लेकिन हमें बीपी तो कम करना है, तो हम उसको नॉर्मल बीपी कम करने के लिए बीटा ब्लॉकर्स देते हैं, जैसे मेटोप्रोलॉल हो गई, एटीनोलॉल हो गई, लेबिटालॉल हो गई, प्रोपोनोलॉल हो गई. तो ये ड्रग्स हम उस व्यक्ति को, उस भले ही उसका बीपी कम करना है हमें, लेकिन हम ये ड्रग उसको नहीं देंगे, क्योंकि हमें उसकी पास्ट मेडिकल हिस्ट्री में क्या पता चला कि उसको अस्थमा की कंडीशन है. नेक्स्ट वन, NSAIDs, नॉन स्टेरॉयडल एंटी इंफ्लामेटरी ड्रग्स. नॉन स्टेरॉयडल एंटी इंफ्लामेटरी ड्रग्स. सो दीज आर सर्टेन ड्रग्स विच इज कॉजिंग इंड्यूसिंग अस्थमेटिक कंडीशन. AIIMS स्पेशल, यहां से क्वेश्चन उठ के आपके आता है. नेक्स्ट वन, so these are the etiology and triggers of asthma. Now I will describe about the pathophysiology of asthma. So let us see, beta adrenergic blockers,
ye drugs kya kar rahi hai, contraindicated in asthma. Write it down fast. Contraindicated in asthma, and it because these drugs, and these are the trigger for triggering the asthmatic condition. Now let us talk about the pathophysiology of asthma. Pathophysiology. So I told you earlier that this is pseudocolumnar epithelial cell. epithelial cell.
This is the
first layer of pseudocolumnar wait.
Pathophysiology. So, I'm making it here to be more visible to you. Let it make it clearly. This is the pseudocolumnar epithelial cell. Suppose, what is actually occurring in the asthma? Let us see. This is the asthmatic patient or an allergic patient comes in an exposure with cigarette smoke, or we can say sulfur dioxide or carbon dioxide or carbon monoxide or any farmer, agricultural dust or animal dander or pollen grains. What is occurring when the smoke or any pollen dust encounters with the pseudocolumnar epithelial cell, then what is actually occurring? See, this pseudocolumnar epithelial cell will release a protein termed as thymus stromal lymphocytic protein. Thymus stromal lymphocytic protein. And what this protein is occurring, this is secreting from the pseudocolumnar epithelial cell. This is a protein which is found in the thymus, and it is a type of a lymphocytic protein which is obviously responsible for your increase in the immunity power. What this TSLP, what is TSLP is doing, thymus stromal lymphocytic protein, stimulating dendritic cell. Note it down, guys. What is dendritic cells? Dendritic cells, these dendritic cells are a part of a WBC. And what is the function of dendritic cell? Dendritic cell has main two functions: first, phagocytosis, and second, increasing immunity power. After this dendritic cell is stimulated, this dendritic cell get activated dendritic cell. What is the function of dendritic cell? Phagocytosis. And second function, increase immunity. Now, after the protein thymus stromal lymphocytic protein is released, that thymus stromal lymphocytic protein is stimulating the dendritic cell. And this dendritic cell, what is the exact function of dendritic cell is phagocytosis and increasing immunity. But in asthma, what dendritic cell is doing? Let us see. Let me delete it. TSLP, thymus stromal lymphocytic protein, activated dendritic cell. Now, suppose this is your blood vessel. This is your blood vessel.
In your blood vessel, this pink one, this is T helper 2 cell. T helper 2 cell is present in the blood vessel,
but T helper cell is used in the immunity. It is a part of a T lymphocyte. So, a T lymphocyte is helpful in increasing in the immunity and fighting against the various encountering stimulus.
Now, what this dendritic cell will do? ये dendritic cell क्या करेगी? With the help of with the help of certain chemoattractants, chemokines, chemo, I am writing it down here, with the help of certain chemoattractants. What are chemoattractants? These are chemical substances which attracts any other chemical substance. These are the chemoattractants. With the help of chemoattractants, this dendritic cell is attracting the T helper cell. This is T helper cell. Attracting this T helper cell, I am writing down here that T helper cell, I am marking it here, T helper cell, I am denoting T helper cell as this circle, this circumscribed inner circle, and this is T helper cell. So, this T helper cell will be from the blood vessel will come, because we need T helper cell in the lungs. We need T helper cell in the lungs to fight against the stimulus, to fight against the allergen of asthma. So, we do not want it in the blood vessel, we want it in the lungs. So, this with the help of chemoattractants, this dendritic cell will stimulate the T helper cell to bring it in the lungs. Now, and this T helper cell and this phenomena is going in the lungs. This is the lungs. Now, from the blood vessel, this T helper cell is present, bring it in the lungs, brought up in the lungs. When I zoomed in the T helper cell, I found certain leukotrienes. What leukotrienes? This is the leukotriene which I made it zoomed in the leukotrienes. Now, what is leukotrienes? Leukotrienes are the part of the chemokines. And what is chemokines? Chemokines is the cell signaling molecules.
and chemokines releases leukotrienes and leukotrienes further releases interleukins. So we will not say it leukotriene. For simplicity, I am mentioning it as interleukins. And what are interleukins? But you must know that what is interleukin? Interleukin is a part of leukotriene and leukotriene is a part of chemokines. And what is chemokines? What is leukotrienes? What is interleukins? Interleukins are a cell signaling molecule. What is cell signaling molecule? Cell signaling molecule means that it gives a certain kind of message or stimulus to other cell to induce an activity or an cascade, chemical cascade. Now, this interleukins, this T helper cell, this T helper cell releases interleukins. First of all, it will release interleukin 4 and interleukin 13. Interleukin 4 and interleukin 13. Two interleukins are released by T helper cells, interleukin 4 and interleukin 13. Now, what is this interleukin 4 and interleukin 13 is doing? Let us see. This interleukin 4 and this interleukin 13, suppose this is a blood vessel. This interleukin 4 and this interleukin 4, IL-4 and this interleukin 13 is stimulating the blood vessel and stimulating the plasma cells to release IgE. What is IgE? IgE is the immunoglobulin. And what is globulin? Globulin is the plasma protein. There are three plasma protein: albumin, globulin and fibrinogen. And what is immunoglobulin? Immunoglobulin is a part of a globulin protein, which is a type of plasma protein. And what is especially IgE? IgE is helpful in the fighting against the stimulus and an allergic condition. IgE released in the allergic condition, and asthma is an allergic disease. And how IgE is formed? IgE production is occurring with the help of T helper cell, and in T helper cell, these TH2 cells is producing interleukin 4 and interleukin 13 to induce plasma cells in the blood vessels to produce IgE. Means, let me delete it, note it down. Let me mention IgE as this is IgE. I am denoting IgE as the arrow. So interleukin 4 and interleukin 13 is stimulating the plasma cells in the blood vessel to produce IgE. So now I have IgE with me. IgE production. one more work of
T. Helper cell
is, let us see. With the help of interleukin, with the help of interleukin 9, here 4 and 13, these interleukins are interleukin 4 and interleukin 13. But now again, with the help of interleukin 9, it produces mast cells. Mast cells with the help of interleukin 4 and interleukin 13, production of the Ig, and with the help of interleukin 9, production of the mast cell. I mentioned in the pathology, back the video again. When you get time, again reverse the video and watch there. Especially I mentioned that the pathological feature, classical pathological feature of the asthma is the increase in the production of IgE and increase in the production of mast cells. And how mast cell is forming? Mast cell is forming with the help of interleukin 9. And how IgE is forming? IgE is forming with the help of interleukin 4 and interleukin 13. And what is exactly is interleukin? Interleukin is the chemical signaling molecule which is responsible for signaling the or stimulating the production of IgE, and IgE is formed with the help of interleukin 4 and interleukin 13, and mast cell is formed with the help of interleukin 9. Now I have two byproducts. First, mast cells with the help of interleukin 9, and second, IgE with the help of interleukin 4 and interleukin 13. Now this mast cell, let me delete it. I have mast cell and I also have Ig, immunoglobulin E with the help of interleukin 4 and 13, Ig with the help of interleukin 9 mast cell. Two byproducts, but separately. तो IgE के बिना mast cell किसी काम का नहीं है, और mast cell के बिना IgE किसी काम की नहीं है. Clear? Now, when these two is formed, they together will combine. To form IgE, or we can say that together will combine to form IgE mast cell IgE complex. Mast cell IgE complex. And when this mast cell IgE complex is formed, then what will happen? It will release histamine. And once histamine is released, then what will happen? Bronchoconstriction, which is the classical sign of
asthma, bronchoconstriction. Why bronchoconstriction occurring? Let me again repeat the pathophysiology for your sake. Pseudocolumnar epithelial cell, when exposed with the cigarette smoke, it releases thymus stromal lymphocytic protein. This thymus stromal lymphocytic protein is activating the dendritic cell, and what is with the help of chemoattractants, with the help of chemoattractants, this dendritic cell is bringing the T helper 2 cell here in the lungs. Now we have T helper 2 cells present in the lungs. Okay. Now this T helper 2 cell releases various chemokines and leukotrienes, and in the form of interleukins. What is interleukins? Interleukins are the cell signaling molecules responsible for inducing a mechanism or a cascade, chemical cascade. So T helper 2, there are basically 4 interleukins used in the asthma: interleukin 13, interleukin 4, interleukin 9 and interleukin 5. I mentioned about 3 interleukins here. Now first one is interleukin 4 and 13. This interleukin 4 and 13 is stimulating the plasma cells to induce the immunoglobulin E. IgE is formed. And again this interleukin 9 is responsible for inducing the mast cells. We have 2 byproducts now: mast cell and immunoglobulin E. Now what will happen, this mast cell and IgE together combine to form mast cell IgE complex. Important one: when the mast cell IgE complex will form, it will release histamine, and once the histamine is released, it will do bronchoconstriction. And once the bronchoconstriction will occur, this is the classical sign of asthma. So one more thing, I talked about bronchoconstriction, but I didn't talk about eosinophil infiltration yet. Now let us see how eosinophil infiltration will occur. Very, very clearly see here. With the help of interleukin 5, this interleukin 5 will stimulate the bone marrow. And this bone marrow will do eosinophilopoiesis, increase in the production of eosinophilopoiesis. But eosinophil is present in the bone marrow, not in the lungs, but we need it in the lungs to fight against the various noxious stimulus. Again this dendritic cell, with the help of chemoattractants or chemokines, will bring the eosinophils from the bone marrow to the mucus, and eosinophilic infiltration will be seen in the mucus of the sputum of the patient, पेशेंट, स्प्यूटम ऑफ द पेशेंट। तो आइसिनोफिलिक इन्फिल्ट्रेशन, ब्रोंको कॉन्स्ट्रिक्शन, एयरवे हाइपर रिस्पॉन्सिवनेस एंड हाइपर इन्फ्लेशन इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक साइन ऑफ अस्थमा। एंड वाई इट इज अकरिंग? ड्यू टू द इंक्रीज इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ मास सेल्स एंड इंक्रीज इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ इम्यूनोग्लोबुलिन ई। दिस मास सेल एंड इम्यूनोग्लोबुलिन ई कंबाइंड टू फॉर्म IgE mast cell complex which releases histamine to with that histamine is responsible for histamine prostaglandins and leukotrienes. This histamine is responsible for bronchoconstriction and in asthma bronchoconstriction, eosinophilic infiltration, airway hyperresponsiveness, hyperinflation, increase in the mast cell production, increase in the IgE production is the classical characteristic sign of asthma. This is AIMS special for you. Now let me summarize the pathophysiology first. Again let me revise it. This smoke is inducing the pseudocolumnar epithelial cell to release thymus stromal lymphocytic protein. This thymus stromal lymphocytic protein will activate the dendritic cell. This dendritic cell with the help of chemoattractants bring the T helper T2 cells from the blood vessels to again in the lungs. Now we have T helper 2 cell in the lungs. Now these T helper 2 cells will release three types of interleukins. What are interleukins? Interleukins are the chemical signaling molecule responsible for inducing the production of mast cell, IgE and eosinophils. Which interleukin will release what? Let us see. Interleukin 4 and 13, first of all, stimulate the plasma cells to induce the plasma protein globulin, and for that globulin, increase in the production of IgE is seen. We have a byproduct now, IgE, but it is of no use. In fact, when mast cell will be not there, there is no use of IgE. Now, T helper 2 cells releases interleukin 9. This interleukin 9 is a chemical signaling protein responsible for the production of the mast cell. Now we have two byproducts with us, IgE and mast cell. This mast cell and this IgE together combine to form IgE mast cell complex. Once the mast cell and IgE complex is formed, it releases the histamine, and this histamine is responsible for bronchoconstriction, which is the characteristic sign of the asthma. Next thing, it also releases another interleukin, interleukin 5, responsible for inducing the bone marrow, and bone marrow will produce eosinophils, that is eosinophilopoiesis. IL-5, interleukin 5, a chemical signaling protein responsible for eosinophilopoiesis. Now with the help of dendritic cell, this eosinophils will, this eosinophils will be there present in the, will be bring brought in the mucosa of the patient and will be seen in the sputum of an asthmatic, cough of an asthmatic patient. So these are the some classical signs of asthma. Now let us discuss about the clinical manifestation of asthma. Clinical manifestation of the asthma. Let us see the clinical manifestation of asthma is first chest tightness. Why chest tightness? Due to the broncho constriction. Next, dyspnea, difficulty in breathing. Why difficulty in breathing? Due to broncho constriction. Next, eucapnic ventilation. Important one. important one for an AIIMS special. This is the AIIMS special one.
What is eucapnic ventilation? Eucapnic ventilation means when the patient is exposed to the cold air such as AC, cooler, etc., moist condition or in cooler condition such as winter, then patient will start doing hyper responsiveness. So this is the, this is called when patient is exposed to the cooler air, he will hyperventilate. So this is called eucapnic hyperventilation. Hyperventilation. Next thing, expiratory wheezing. Why expiratory wheezing? Because suppose this is the lumen and this is the mucus. This is the lumen and this is the mucus. So when the patient will inspire, this lumen will dilate. Why? Due to the expansion of the lungs. But once the patient will expire, what will happen? Due to the elastic recoil of the lungs, this mucus, this tenacious mucus, this thick tenacious mucus will stick together, and when it gets stick together, there will be problem in the expiration of CO2. So that a sound, a whistling sound is produced. Whistling sound is termed as wheezing. This is called expiratory wheezing. And due to that, bronchoconstriction. Next feature we will see here, air tapping. Air tapping is also seen in COPD, I mentioned. Air trapping is also seen in asthmatic condition, and air trapping, for that air trapping, hyperinflation will occur. Nocturnal episode, a nocturnal worsening. Next classical symptom. What is nocturnal worsening? Because night is cooler in comparison to the day. So in cooler conditions, bronchoconstriction occurs naturally. In natural lungs also, in cooler condition, in night condition, bronchoconstriction occurs naturally. But in asthmatic condition, it is already bronchoconstricted, and when night, bronchoconstriction will occur. So in night, that chest episode will worse, and then that is we are calling termed as nocturnal worsening. Next one. Thick tenacious sputum. We'll see. Next one is eosinophilic infiltration. So these are some common classical manifestation of asthmatic condition. I hope you like the video, you understand the video. Let you all be the literary giant, let you all be blossom into your heightened possibilities in internal medicine. I hope you like the video. Kindly do not forget to share it to the needy ones. Thank you. Namaskar.